Hi, in this video we will understand how to download and install CodeBlock software and configure FreeGLUT 3.0.0 library to run OpenGL programs in Windows 7, Windows 8.1 and Windows 10 environment. First, you need to download CodeBlock software. To download CodeBlock software, you follow this particular path. Once you download the CodeBlock software, you need to install CodeBlock in your Windows environment. Also, you need to download FreeGLUT 3.0.0 library. To download, follow this particular path. The links to download CodeBlock software and FreeGLUT 3.0.0 is given in the description below. Follow those particular links to download both the softwares. Once you download the softwares, click on the CodeBlock 17.12 MinGW setup .exe file so that you can install that software into Windows environment. Click on yes. It will take some time to install the software. First you need to click on next, then click on I agree. Select all these particular checkbox. Make sure that none of these were left blank, and then click on next again. Select a folder where you want to install it. In Windows 64-bit operating system, it will be installed in program files and x86 folder. If it is a 32-bit operating system, the code blocks will be installed in program files by default. So better not to change this particular directory. Make sure that it will be installed in the default directory where it is showing. Now click on install button. It will take some time to install this software. Once the software is installed, then we will try to configure the FreeGLUT into Windows environment. So we will pause for a second so that it will get installed. Once it is installed, we will come back and understand how to configure FreeGLUT in Windows environment. Once the CodeBlock software is successfully installed, it will ask a question like, do you want to run the CodeBlocks now? For time being, click on no, because we have not yet configured FreeGLUT into Windows environment. So we will not run the CodeBlock software over here. So click on no in this case. Click on next and then finish the installation process. Now the next step is to configure FreeGLUT into Windows environment. So we have already downloaded that FreeGLUT 3.0.0. We will extract that zip file. Once you extract, you will get different files like bin, include and library. We need to copy these particular files into different locations. So first what we do is we will open this include directory, and then we will open GL directory. We have four files. Copy all these four files and then move on to the C directory where you have installed the code blocks. In my case, it is a 32-bit operating system, so I need to select program files. If it is a 64-bit operating system, you need to select program files bracket x86. So I will select program files and then I will select code blocks. Within code blocks, I will select min-gw and then I will select include. Within this, we have a folder called as GL. In this particular folder, we need to paste all the four files what we have copied here. Now, once you copy all the files in this GL folder, we will go back to the same FreeGLUT file where we have downloaded it. And then we will go to the bin library or the bin folder. In this bin folder, we have one DLL file. Copy that particular DLL file, again go to C, select the Windows, and then here there are two possibilities are there. If it is a 32-bit operating system, we need to copy this particular file into system32, that is the system32 folder. We will find it here. Copy that particular DLL in this particular directory. If it is a 64-bit operating system, you need to find a folder called as syswow64. I will repeat one more time. you need to find a folder called syswo64 in Windows directory, and then you need to copy that DLL file over here. Next, we need to go back to the same glut library, and then within lib we have two files, libfreeglut.a, libfreeglut_static.a. Copy these two files, again go to C drive, select program files if it is a 32-bit operating system, or select program files x86 for 64-bit operating system. Select code blocks, select min-gw, select lib here, and then paste those two files here. So once you paste that particular file, we have copied all the files from downloaded directories into the different locations. Next, we need to update two files. For that, first select C directory, go to program files, select code blocks. Within that, you will find a share directory. Again, select code blocks, and then select templates. Here we need to search for glut.cbp file. glut.cbp file. Open that particular file in a Notepad or Notepad++ or any editor, and then you need to find for glut32, and then replace that particular glut32 with free glut. Then click on replace all. After that, save this particular file. It will ask the administrator mode. Click on yes again. Click on yes. It will reopen, and then click on save. So once you save this particular file, close this particular notepad. Go back to this particular templates folder again. Within templates folder, you will find one more directory that is called wizard. Within wizard, you will find a directory called glut. In this glut, you have a file called as wizard.script. Open this particular file in again any editor. In my case, I am using Notepad++. Again, find free glut, glut32, and replace all occurrence of glut32 with free glut over here. So I will click replace all, and then I will close this particular folder by saving it. Again, it will ask the administrator mode. So you need to click on yes and yes. It will reopen again, and then you need to save it once. So once you save this particular folder file, the configuration of free glut in Windows environment is over. Now you can open the code block software, and then you can run your OpenGL programs. Once you open the code block IDE, next you need to click on either create a new project, or click on file, select new, and then select a project here. So once you select a project, you need to select one among these different possibilities. In our case, we want to create a glut project, so create click on glut project here. So once you click on glut project, it will give you the welcome message. Click on next. Here you can give the name of your project. You can give any name. You can select the path where you want to store your programs, and then it will generate one more file called as demo.cbp. Again, it will be stored into the same folder here. Click on next. Here you need to select the glut location. In my case, the glut location is program files code blocks slash min-gw. If it is a 64-bit operating system, the program files x86 you need to select. If you want to select this particular the glut location, you click on this triple dot and then select that particular path here. Once you do that thing, next click on next button. Here make sure that the compiler selected is GNU GCC compiler here. If everything is fine, click on finish button. Once you click on finish button, a new project will be created. On the left panel, you can see the projects. The name of the project is demo, and there is a folder called as sources here. Click on plus. You will get the main.cpp file here. Double click on that main.cpp. A standard program will be displayed to you. This is the standard program which will be installed with respect to Freeglut 3.0.0. You can use this for demonstration purpose or to check whether the Freeglut is configured correctly or not. Next, click on build. You can compile the current file or you can run it. But what you need to do is you need to build and run that particular file. So click on build and run. It will take some time, first time, to compile your program. Now, if everything is fine, like installing code blocks and configuring Freeglut 3.0.0 in Windows environment, you will get the output like this. If you get the output like this, the meaning is whatever the configuration you have done with respect to Freeglut 3.0.0 is perfect. You can use this software for executing your OpenGL programs. This is the process you need to follow to download code blocks, Freeglut, and configuring Freeglut in Windows environment. I hope the process is clear. If you like the video, do like the video and share the video with your friends. Press the subscribe button for more videos. Press the bell icon for regular updates. Thank you for watching.